throne was flames of fire, with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out of the earth and sand. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As visions during the night continue, I saw one like a son of man coming on clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All nations and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To jest w tym sekundowanym, który nam upodobają. through our world.
Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, behold, a bright light cast a shadow over them, and from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Rise and do not be afraid." And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. And as they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, "Do not tell this vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to the Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm not one for telling a lot of stories during homilies, but I only have one story that relates to a passage from today's gospel, and it involves a little bit of diocesan history, but I'll only tell you if you want to hear it. So do you want to hear it?
Yes.
Everyone should be familiar with Cardinal Kroll, priest-son of the Cleveland Diocese, who was auxiliary bishop here, then became the Archbishop of Philadelphia. Amongst his friends from his young days was Monsignor Pugielski, who headed the cemeteries, the son of St. Casimir Church. Monsignor Mungileski was my pastor growing up at St. Peter and Paul Church in Garden Heights. Now, when the cardinal would come in from vacation, oftentimes they'd spend the day getting together, they'd go out for a round of golf, come back that afternoon, freshen up, and then go out for a nice dinner somewhere. Well, one day they did this, and they came in, and the cardinal had to use the facilities. And so Monsignor said, "Oh, don't bother going up to your room. The associate's room's right here. It's his day off. He never comes on his day off." So Cardinal changed, took a shower, he grabbed a sports page, he sat on the throne because, you know, cardinals like thrones. And then he lit a big stogie and he's reading the paper. Well, wouldn't you know, the one time in 3 years, the associate came back. And what's the first thing he had to do? He had to go to use the facilities. So he walks into his room, he opens the door to the bathroom, and there's the cardinal in all his glory, reading the paper, smoking a stogie. He turns to him and says, "Speak of this vision to no one." And you know how I know that priest didn't listen? I just told you the story, didn't I? Well, today we celebrate the Feast of the Transfiguration, which is in the timeline of the Gospels, sort of towards the end. It's what happened just before Palm Sunday, where Jesus heads back to Jerusalem to suffer and die for us. So it's like a sneak preview, not of the passion of death, but the glory of the resurrection, to strengthen the faith of the apostles, Peter, James, and John, being the principals among them. Because the Lord knew how hard it was going to be, and they didn't understand. So you need to remember this. And even after seeing that, what happened to the passion? It all ran away. And Peter even denied knowing Jesus. That's why it wasn't until after the resurrection, where Peter, in hindsight, in our second reading, testifies to having seen the book and having heard the voice of the Father, and therefore knowing that we must listen to his Son, Jesus. But the Transfiguration itself is a classic example of a, here's your $10 theological word for today, a theandric act. Theandric act. It's when the divinity of Jesus shines through his humanity. Because normally Jesus walks around, he looks just like us. He does signs and wonders. But he looks no different from anyone else. His humanity cloaks the divinity. But in certain occasions, and this being the primordial one, you see the exact opposite. The divinity shines through the humanity. because that transfiguration was a special spiritual event. Most people are not going to knock off their horse, like St. Paul on the road to Damascus, because not everybody needs a special shot in the arm. Most people, God feels, can get by with what he's given them, can get by with the testimony, the witness of the faith throughout the years. Now, certain people do get that special spiritual something, but usually, watch out, that means more work. Mother Teresa got it. St. Paul got it. Many people get it, but it usually means God has got a special plan for you. Does that mean we're less important? No. It means God thinks we need less help. Why? Why would God think we need less help? Because he's given us all the help we need already. Notice, how did those disciples end up on the mountain? Jesus invited them to come along. They said yes. Therefore, they're witnesses to what took place in the mountain. They don't say yes, they don't go. No stone. So, how are we like the apostles? First of all, you said yes to the Lord. You know how I know? You're here. Whether you were baptized as an infant or brought into the church through, you know, the faith of others, somewhere along the line, you said yes to the Lord because now you stand on your own 2 feet spiritually. So you said yes to the Lord. What does that mean? That means Jesus is walking with you on the journey. The journey is going towards that light, that bright light of the resurrection. But along the way, what do we encounter? We encounter the troubles of life. Who doesn't have troubles? Who doesn't have doubts? Who doesn't have difficulty? Who in our world doesn't have to put up with a society that exalts that which is wrong and puts down that which is right? It's not easy. And that's why God doesn't expect us to go alone. Remember, Jesus is already walking with us. And as I like to remind everyone, that is the recipe for success right from the scripture. Alone, Jesus said, you can do nothing. With God, all things are possible. Today is a reminder that the possibilities aren't at the end of the line when we too experience the glory of the resurrection. The possibilities are all along the journey because we are walking with Jesus, who is the key to unlocking them in our life. And so, today, we thank the Lord for this feast falling on a Sunday because it reminds us of an important thing in Jesus' life, but also an important thing in our life. God is with us, and it makes all the difference in the world. Мы дорожі Христу Шикана, чішайте Евангелія, вшенте кьокнули, пані, добже, що ту єстеш. Вшенте вчинення Майнського показує нам, що варто чимовати запрошення Єсуса до спільного вендрування через життя. Указує теж певний процес дочарання до Бога, відкривання Бога і життя перед Богом завжди. Ініціатива завжди виходить від Єсуса. To on zaprasza nas, abyśmy razem z nim weszli na górę uczynienia. Nam również chce ukazać swoje prawdziwe oblicze. Chce, abyśmy mogli poznać go takim, jakim naprawdę jest. Chce, abyśmy dostrzegli w nim przyjaciela, który wie o nas wszystko i kocha nas takim, jakimi jesteśmy teraz, a jednocześnie opowiada nam, jacy możemy być. Takie doświadczenie osobistego, przemieniającego spotkanie z Jezusem, pomaga zmieniać nasze życie, nawracać się, iść inną drogą. By to podjąć potrzeba naszej współpracy, pewnego wysiłku, zmiany planów, myślenia czy bycia. Uczniowie po przemienieniu wrócili do swojej codziennej zajęć. Ubogacenne doświadczenie oglądania farbnego oblicza Chrystusa. My także po spotkaniu z Jezusem podczas Eucharystii, konfesjonale, czasie lektury Pisma Świętego, czy na innym modlitwie wracamy do codzienności. Wracamy jednak do I sam cierpię liczną do trwania z nim i słyszenie innym ludziom. Tylko wtedy, gdy w nim trwa, dokonuje się przemiany nas samych i środowiska, w którym żyjemy. Dobrze jest więc żyć blisko Jezusa. Wtedy bliska widzimy najlepsze i najwyraźniejsze przykłady naśladowania. Wtedy dokładnie słyszymy głos, który wskazuje drogę bezpieczną i pewną. Wtedy namacalnie odczuwamy pomoc kogoś, kto jest zawsze blisko i nie zawodzi. To doświadczenie wzmacnia naszą wiarę i pozwala dzielić się nią z innymi, dając świadectwo o spotkaniu z żyjącym Chrystusem. Dlatego pośród zwykłych spraw, codziennych zajęć i obowiązków, a także podczas wakacyjnego, wypoczynku warto zawalczyć o czas na modlitwę, na doświadczenie osobistego spotkania z Jezusem w naszym życiu. On przecież zawsze jest blisko nas. Im ciężej sobie to uświadamiamy, im ciężej nasz wzrok spotyka się z Jego przemienionym obliczem, tym bardziej nasze życie zaczyna nabierać piękny fakt i kształt. Lekcja, której my, chrześcijanie, nie powinniśmy nigdy zapominać.
Thank you. Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Thank you.
May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you will to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Just a couple announcements before our final blessing and dismissal. First, we're privileged to have you in the presence of the Pilgrim Persian statue of Our Lady of Fatima, our diocesan statue, which was blessed by St. John Paul
anyone wants a short tour, folks, I'm available, okay? I'll get started in about 5 minutes or so. Or you want your picture taken too, I can do that.
Yesterday, Hannah and Julia from